تعالى البدر علينا من ثنيات الوداع وجب الشكر علينا ما دعا لله داع Oh the white moon rolls over us from the valley of Wada and we owe it to show gratefulness where the call is to Allah
He will tell you that it is very natural that you Muslims will talk good things about the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. वो कहेंगे आपसे कि ये बहुत natural है कि आप मुसलमान मोहम्मद सल्लल्लाहु अलैहि वसल्लम के बारे में जब बोलेंगे तो अच्छा ही बोलेंगे. तो हम लोग देखें कि गैर मुसलमान मोहम्मद सल्लल्लाहु अलैहि वसल्लम के बारे में क्या बोल रहे हैं. एक शख्सियत है गैर मुसलमान माइकल एच हार्ट को एक किताब लिखे हैं द 100 रैंकिंग ऑफ द मोस्ट इन्फ्लुएंशियल पर्सन इन हिस्ट्री. दुनिया में हिस्टोरिकल रिकॉर्ड्स में जितने भी इंसान आ चुके हैं जिसके हिस्टोरिकल रिकॉर्ड्स रखा गया हो उसमें से टॉप 100 सबसे जबरदस्त लोग वो चुने हैं. वो एक नसारा है ईसाई और वो नंबर वन पोजीशन में मोहम्मद सल्लल्लाहु अलैहि वसल्लम को डाले हैं. वो खुद नसरानी है लेकिन उसके बावजूद वो मोहम्मद सल्लल्लाहु अलैहि वसल्लम के नंबर वन स्पॉट दिए हुए हैं. और खुद अपने नबी ईसा अलैहि सलाम अपने खुदा अस्तगफिरुल्लाह ईसा अलैहि सलाम को नंबर 3 पोजीशन में डाले हुए हैं. इससे पता चलता है कि ही इज बीइंग ऑनेस्ट अनबायस होके अगर कोई देखेंगे तो वो मोहम्मद सल्लल्लाहु अलैहि वसल्लम को नंबर 1 में रखेंगे. और वो उन्होंने फर्दर लिखते हैं अपनी किताब में दिस रैंकिंग दैट आई हैव गिवन इट मे बी क्वेश्चनेबल बाय सम सो एंड आई डिमांड एन एक्सप्लेनेशन. सो ही सेज दैट ही वाज द ओनली पर्सन इन हिस्ट्री हु वाज सुप्रीमली सक्सेसफुल ऑन बोथ द रिलीजियस एंड द सेक्युलर लेवल्स. दैट इज व्हाई ही हैज बीन प्लेस्ड नंबर 1. And further, Alphonse D. Lamartine, he says that if greatness of purpose, smallness of means, and astonishing results are the 3 criteria to judge human greatness, who dare compare any other man in history with Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam? That means, according to Alphonse D. Lamartine, किसी शख्स को कंपेयर करना बेवकूफी है मोहम्मद सल्लल्लाहु अलैहि वसल्लम से. मतलब वो सबसे बेहतर शख्स जैसे कुरान फरमाता है सूरह अहज़ाब चैप्टर 21 ही हैव इंडीड इन द मैसेंजर ऑफ अल्लाह एक्सीलेंट एग्जांपलर. और फर्दर इन द सूरह अल-कलम चैप्टर 60 वर्स नंबर 4 एंड ओ प्रॉफिट थाउ स्टैंडेस्ट ऑन द हाईएस्ट स्टैंडर्ड ऑफ कैरेक्टर. फर्दर ही हैज बीन प्रेज्ड बाय अ लॉट ऑफ स्कॉलर्स जैसे कि A.S. ट्रिटन बर्नार्ड शॉ मॉन्टेग ओपली गांधी रामकृष्ण राव. The list is endless and we can talk on this issue for long hours, but due to the time constraints I'll move to other issues. A non-Muslim will tell you, okay, you agree that Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam is a great man, we agree that, but why should we follow him and him alone, and is it the only way to salvation? So you have to inform him, yes indeed he is the only way to salvation. The Quran makes a thing very clear. It is not just Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. If you deny any prophet of Allah, as mentioned in Surah Baqarah chapter 20 verse 136, if you deny any of the prophets of Allah, then you are out of the fold of Islam. Agar aap deny kar rahe hain kisi bhi nabi ko, Allah ke bheje hue nabi ko, to aap Islam se kharij ho ja rahe hain. Sirf Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam ne. Wo kya galti kar rahe hain? Wo Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam ko nahi maan rahe. Aur agar koi dusre bhi nabi jo aaye hue hain उसको भी इनकार करें उसके लिए मूर्ति हो तो वो भी इस्लाम से खारिज. इस्लाम मेक्स इट ऑब्लिगेटरी ऑन ऑल ऑफ अस टू बिलीव ईच एंड एवरी प्रॉफिट एंड फर्दर ऑल द प्रॉफिट्स हु केम ऑन द फेस ऑफ द अर्थ इज क्लैरिफाइड इन सूरह शूरा चैप्टर 42 वर्स नंबर 13 दैट ऑल ऑफ देम प्रीच्ड द सेम रिलीजन द रिलीजन ऑफ इस्लाम. ऑल ऑफ देम हैड द सेम issue at the same purpose to preach the religion of Islam, nothing else. So let us now delve into some of the prophecies which has been prophesied in the various major world religious scriptures about the Prophet Muhammad, the last Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. First we will discuss about the prophecies in Judeo-Christian scriptures, the Bible. The Bible, as we know, is divided into 2 parts, the Old Testament and the New Testament. The Old Testament contains Torah, which is called the Torah. It also contains Psalms or Zabur. It also contains some other books. The New Testament contains Injil or Gospel. It also contains some other books. Before I proceed further, I'd like to clarify that these books are not the original books which were sent to the respective prophets. These are corrupted form of the books. Allah clearly mentions in Surah Hijr, chapter number 15, verse number 9, that we have assuredly sent the Quran and we shall assuredly guard it from corruption. Allah farmate hain, is Quran ko main zimmedari leke rakha hu ki isko मिलावट होने नहीं दूंगा। अल्लाह खुद जिम्मेदार, अल्लाह खुद जिम्मेदार जिम्मेदारी लेके रखे हैं कि कुरान में मिलावट होने नहीं देंगे। इससे क्या पता चलता है? दो चीजें पता चलती है। एक तो ये कि कुरान में कभी तब्दीली नहीं होगी, और दूसरी चीज ये पता चलता है कि पिछली नाजिल में जितने भी किताब है सब मिलावट हो चुकी है। इस आयत से साफ साफ होता है। सो द फर्स्ट प्रोफेसी विच आई लाइक टू प्रेजेंट इन फ्रंट ऑफ यू इज फ्रॉम द ओल्ड टेस्टामेंट, फ्रॉम द टोरा, द करप्टेड फॉर्म, इन द बुक ऑफ डिट्रोनमी चैप्टर नंबर 18 वर्स नंबर 18 विच सेज, आई विल रेज देम अप अ प्रॉफिट फ्रॉम अमंग देयर ब्रदरन लाइक अन टू दी, एंड विल पुट माय वर्ड्स इन हिज माउथ एंड ही शैल स्पीक ऑल दैट आई शैल कमांड हिम। गौर करें, मैं दोहरा रहा हूं। डिट्रोनमी चैप्टर नंबर 18 वर्स नंबर 18 सेज, आई विल रेज देम अप अ प्रॉफिट फ्रॉम अमंग देयर ब्रदरन लाइक अन टू दी, and I shall put my words in his mouth and he shall speak all that I shall command him। part by part हम देख रहे हैं prophecy क्या deal करता है। पहले अगर इस prophecy को आप पूछेंगे किसी नसारा से, क्रिश्चियन से, तो बोलेंगे ये prophecy deal कर रहा है ईसा अलैहि सलाम, ईसा अलैहि सलाम को indicate कर रहे हैं। आपको उनको बताना पड़ेगा ये prophecy ईसा अलैहि सलाम को indicate नहीं कर रहा है। तो बोलेंगे क्यों नहीं कर रहे भाई? तो आप बोलेंगे ये इसलिए नहीं कह रहे हैं क्योंकि द प्रोफेसी डज नॉट फिट, ईसा अलैहि सलाम डज नॉट फुलफिल द प्रोफेसी, द रिक्वायरमेंट्स ऑफ द प्रोफेसी। व्हाट आर द रिक्वायरमेंट्स? द रिक्वायरमेंट क्लियरली सेज, अल्लाह इज़ टेलिंग मूसा अलैहि सलाम, अल्लाह खिताब करे मूसा अलैहि सलाम से, वो नबी जो आएंगे फ्यूचर में जो आएंगे वो आप जैसे होंगे, लाइक अन टू दी आप जैसे होंगे, ऐ मूसा आप जैसे होंगे। तो हम देखते हैं कि ईसा अलैहि सलाम क्या मूसा अलैहि सलाम जैसे थे या मोहम्मद सल्लल्लाहु अलैहि वसल्लम मूसा अलैहि सलाम जैसे थे? पहली बात, मूसा अलैहि सलाम की वालदैन, दोनों वालदैन थे, वालिद वालिदा दोनों थे। मोहम्मद सल्लल्लाहु अलैहि वसल्लम की वालदा वालिद वालिदा दोनों थे। ईसा अलैहि सलाम की सिर्फ वालिदा, इस मदर वाज ओनली प्रेजेंट, इस फादर वाज नॉट देयर। सो जीसस पीस बी अपॉन हिम इज नॉट लाइक मोसेस पीस बी अपॉन हिम, बट मोहम्मद पीस बी अपॉन हिम इज लाइक मोसेस पीस बी अपॉन हिम। फर्दर देयर बर्थ, both Moses peace be upon him and Muhammad peace be upon him were born in a natural birth, but Jesus peace be upon him had a miraculous birth without any male intervention, which many modern day Christians do not believe, but it is mentioned in the Bible as well, mentioned in the Quran, that it is a miraculous birth. So Jesus peace be upon him was not like Moses peace be upon him, but Muhammad peace be upon him was like Moses peace be upon him. Further, both Moses peace be upon him and Muhammad peace be upon him brought new laws, नए शरीयत लाए हैं दोनों। ईसा अलैहि सलाम कोई नए शरीयत नहीं लाए हैं, इंजील शरीयत की किताब नहीं है। मैं खुद ईसा अलैहि सलाम का बयान इंजील से बयान कर रहा हूँ जो कि मौजूद है गॉस्पल ऑफ मैथ्यू चैप्टर नंबर 5 वर्स नंबर 17 एंड 18 में। थिंक नॉट दैट आई हैव कम टू डिस्ट्रॉय द लॉ ऑफ द प्रॉफिट्स, आई हैव नॉट कम टू डिस्ट्रॉय बट टू फुलफिल, फॉर वेरीली आई से अनटू यू टिल हेवन एंड अर्थ पास वन जॉट और वन टिटल शैल इन नो वाइज पास टिल ऑल बी फुलफिल। ईसा अलैहि सलाम साफ जाहिर कर रहे हैं उनका मकसद सिर्फ यही था कि दोबारा मोज़ाइक लॉ, जो शरीयत जो मूसा अलैहि सलाम पे उतारा गया था उसको नाफिज करना, सिर्फ उसी मकसद से वो भेजे गए थे। सो अगेन वी सी दैट जीसस पीस बी अपॉन हिम वॉज नॉट लाइक मोसेस पीस बी अपॉन हिम, बट मोहम्मद पीस बी अपॉन हिम वॉज लाइक मोसेस पीस बी अपॉन हिम। फर्दर, बोथ मोसेस पीस बी अपॉन हिम एंड मोहम्मद पीस बी अपॉन हिम बोथ वर प्रॉफिट्स एज वेल एज किंग, बट जीसस पीस बी अपॉन हिम वॉज ओनली अ प्रॉफिट, ही वॉज नॉट अ किंग। एज इज मेंशन इन जोसेफ ऑफ जॉन चैप्टर नंबर 18 वर्स नंबर 36 दैट माय किंगडम is not of this world. He says that he is a spiritual kingdom. His kingdom is of spiritual nature only. That means he only claims to be a prophet. He does not claim to be a king. So all these prophecies, and moreover, both Moses peace be upon him and Muhammad peace be upon him died and were buried. But Jesus peace be upon him was raised up alive, which is mentioned in Surah Nisa chapter 4, verse number 157 and 150. It is also mentioned in the Bible. The Holy Quran, chapter number 4, verse number 157 and 158 says that they killed him not, neither did they crucify him. It is only conjectures that they follow. They killed him not, neither did they crucify him, but it was made to appear so. And those who disbelieve therein is full of doubts, and with only conjectures to follow. For surely they killed him not. Allah Ta'ala saaf kar rahe hain ki Isa alaihi salam ko utha liya gaya hai, unko maut hui nahi. So these similarities with Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam and Musa alaihi salam indicate that the prophet indicated in Deuteronomy chapter number 18 verse number 18 clearly specifies, refers to Prophet Muhammad peace be upon him and not to Prophet Jesus peace be upon him. Further, आप न्यू टेस्टामेंट में देखेंगे लिखा हुआ है गॉस्पेल ऑफ जॉन में चैप्टर नंबर 1 वर्स नंबर 20 वर्स नंबर 21 यहूदी लोग बहुत परेशान कर रहे थे जॉन द बैप्टिस्ट यहीए अलैहिस्सलाम को, तो दो तीन सवाल पूछे थे यहीए अलैहिस्सलाम को, क्या आप मसीह हैं, क्या आप इलियास हैं, क्या आप वो नबी हैं? ही वॉज आस्क्ड थ्री स्पेसिफिक क्वेश्चन, आर्ट द क्राइस्ट, आर्ट द इलियास, what art thou that prophet? Three questions. If that prophet and this prophet, which prophet is being asked? The Jews were awaiting a prophet which was indicated in the Old Testament. Old Testament mein likha hua hai ki Musa alaihi salam jaise nabi aayenge aur us nabi ke intezar mein yahudi the. They were waiting for him, for the arrival of the last prophet. And so they question him, why baptizest thou when thou art not the Christ, not Elias, not that prophet? Which prophet? The prophet of Deuteronomy 18:18, which we have proved that it is none other but Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam in Psalm 1, chapter number 110 verse number 1, in Matthew chapter number 11 verse number 11, and in Malachi chapter number 3 verse number 1, and Haggai chapter number 2 verse number 7. The last reference, Haggai chapter number 2 verse number 7 says, and the Muhammad of all nations, sallallahu alaihi wasallam, is will surely come. Bible saaf kiye de raha hai ki wo nabi jo hai, the last prophet, the Bible's last prophet, which is none but the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, is surely going to come. And this is also mentioned in the Holy Quran in Surah Saf, chapter number 61, verse number 6. Isa alaihi wasallam bol rahe hain, I confirm the law which came before you and give you glad tidings of a prophet to come after me, and his name shall be Ahmad. And we know that Prophet Muhammad's another name was is Ahmad. So all these prophecies clearly indicate that the Bible's last prophet, as well as the Quran's last prophet, is the same and one. It is none other than Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Next, we discuss a few prophecies from the Hindu scriptures. That who is the Hindu's last prophet mentioned in the Hindu scriptures? Before I proceed further, let me make it very clear that I am not quoting to suggest their authenticity, the authenticity of those books. We don't agree that those books are authentic. This is not my purpose. But what is the problem? The problem is they are considering that to be their authority. So you present in the Quran, agree well and good. If you don't agree with the Quran, agree with what? Agree with your scriptures, look what your scripture says. Every scripture has been corrupted. From no scripture can we understand the complete religion which was revealed by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Even if we agree that these books might have been revealed to some prophet. So the purpose is very clear. It is only to convince them from their own scriptures, own authority, that look, your authority speaks and tells you to believe Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam has been prophesied in several places in Hindu scriptures. He has been prophesied in Bhavishya Quran, Prati Sarpar 3, 103 Adhyay 3, Shlokas 5 to 8, where it is mentioned a foreign spiritual teacher, a foreign means a person who speaks foreign language and stays in a foreign country, spiritual teacher will arise in Arabia, and this Mahadev Arab will be of angelic disposition and will be sinless, and with the help of his companions he will kill the devil, that is abolish idol worship etc. and all the vices which were present during the Yom Jahiliyyah, during the days of ignorance. And his name will be Muhammad. The Sanskrit given is Muhammad. So here also Prophet Muhammad peace be upon him has been mentioned by his name in this reference of Bhavishya Quran, Parva 303, Adhyay 3, Shlokas 5 to 8. Further, in the same chapter, in verses 10 to 27, It gives a more elaborate prophecy of the last prophet, of the Antim Rishi to come, which says that this person, the last prophet, he will be chosen by Brahma, Ishwar Paramatma, by God Almighty, and he will guide these ignorant people from Jahiliya unto Haq. He will bring them from darkness to light. And further, this prophet will say that the religion of truth, Arya Dharma, is bound to prevail. The religion of truth, Arya Dharma, is bound to prevail over all religions. And I shall be the originator of this religion of meat eaters, and my followers will be men circumcised. They will not have a shindy, a tail on the head. They will keep a beard. They will create a revolution. They will give the call for the azan, the prayer. They will not be purified by herbs or shrubs, but will be purified by warfare. And on account of their fighting with the irreligious nations, they will be called Muslims. They will be called Muslims. This prophecy once again clearly indicates that the last prophet to come refers to no one else but Prophet Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. As the prophecy clearly indicates, the pattern, way of life of the followers of Prophet Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam and the present day Muslims indicate that it is we, that is the Muslims, whom the Hindu scripture is referring to. Further, he has also been prophesized in Atharva Ved, book number 20, hymn number 127, verses 1 to 14. The first verse of this portion of Atharva Ved says that he will be Narasansha. The Sanskrit word Narasansha means a man who is praiseworthy. And in Arabic, the word is Muhammad. So the word Arabic word Muhammad, when translated in Sanskrit, is Narasansha. So this once again clearly indicates that the prophet to come refers, as the last prophet in Hinduism, refers to Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. Moreover, verse number 2 gives a more elaborate discussion. It says that he will not be a camel riding rishi. This indicates that he will not be an Indian rishi. This indicates that he will be a foreign rishi. The Antim Rishi to come, mentioned in the Hindu scriptures, will be a foreign rishi. Why? Because Manusmriti, chapter number 11, verse number 202, tells us that a Brahmin cannot ride a camel or an ass. A Brahmin is not allowed to ride a camel or an ass. And the prophet says that this rishi, the Antim Rishi to come, will be a camel riding rishi. So this prophecy once again indicates that it refers to Prophet Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. And the verses continue. I'll mention the last verse, verse number 14, which makes it obligatory on all Hindus to believe in the last prophet when that last prophet comes. Maharishi Vyas indicates in the prophecy that you Hindus, you should believe in the last prophet when he comes to remain a Hindu. So to remain Hindu, to follow Hinduism, you should believe in this last prophet. And once you accept this last prophet, you become a Muslim. There are several other prophecies about Prophet Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam in the Hindu scriptures. Time does not permit us to discuss, give an elaborate discussion on all. I'll give you a reference of a few of the prophecies. They have also been prophesied in Atharva Ved, book number 20, hymn number 127, verses 1 to 14. Atharva Ved, book number 20, hymn number 21, verse number 6. Atharva Ved, book number 20, hymn number 21, verses 7 to 9. Has also been mentioned by the name Ahmad in Samved, Uttarachik Mantra number 1500, in Samved, Indra, chapter number 2, verse number 152. He has been prophesied as Narasansha in several places, in Rig Ved, book number 1, hymn number 13, verse number 3, Rig Ved, book number 1, hymn number 18, verse number 9, Rig Ved, book number 1, hymn number 106, verse number 4, Rig Ved, book number 1, hymn number 142, verse number 3, Rig Ved, book number 2, hymn number 3, verse number 2, Rig Ved, book number 5, hymn number 5, verse number 2, Rig Ved, book number 7, hymn number 2, verse number 2, Rig Ved, book number 10, hymn number 64, verse number 3, Rig Ved, book number 10, hymn number 182, verse number 2, Yajur Ved, chapter number 20, verse number 37, Yajur Ved, chapter number 20, verse number 57, Yajur Ved, chapter number 21, verse number 31, Yajur Ved, chapter number 31, 21, verse number 55, Ezekiel chapter number 28, verse number 2, Ezekiel chapter number 28, verse number 19, Ezekiel chapter number 28, verse number 42, and the list is goes on and on, it's endless. These were some of the prophecies which is mentioned in the Hindu scriptures about Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Next, we move on to the prophecies of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam in the Zoroastrian scriptures. In the Zoroastrian scriptures, Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam has been mentioned in Zend Avesta, Parvadin Yash, chapter number 28, verse number 129. This prophecy in Zend Avesta says that he will be victorious. This prophet will be victorious. His name will be Sushan, and his name will be Astavet Arita. The Sushan, the beneficent one, will benefit the whole of humanity, because as a bodily creature, he will protect the bodily world and will stand against the two-footed brood and will stand against the errors of the idolaters and against the mistakes of the Mesdinians. This prophecy indicates that he will benefit the whole of humanity, as is mentioned in chapter number 20, verse number 107, in Surah Anbiya, chapter 21, verse number 107. وَمَا أَرْسَلْنَاكَ إِلَّا رَحْمَةً لِلْعَالَمِينَ. We have sent thee not but as a mercy for the whole of humanity. We have sent you as a mercy for all the creatures. And moreover, the prophecy says that he will be victorious. And Prophet Muhammad was victorious during Fateh Mecca. Moreover, it says he will be beneficent, he will be merciful. And Prophet Muhammad after Fateh Mecca said that there shall be no reproof against you this day. There will be no revenge on you this day. Moreover, he has been mentioned by the word Sushan. Sushan, if you refer to Hastings Encyclopedia, means praiseworthy, which in Arabic, translated in Arabic, means Muhammad, peace be upon him. And the word Astavet Arita is derived from the root word Astu, which in Sanskrit as well as in Zen means to praise. It can also be derived from the word Sitauda, which means praising, or the Persian word Istadan, which means to raise. All these indicate the word Astavet Arita means one who praises, or as in Arabic, translated in Arabic, it is Ahmad, peace be upon him. So this prophecy indicates the last prophet, Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, by both his names, Muhammad, peace be upon him, as well as Ahmad, peace be upon him. Further, it is mentioned in Zend Avesta, Parvadin Yash, in Zamiyad Yash, chapter number 16, verse number 95, Zend Avesta, Zamiyad Yash, chapter number 16, verse number 95, that his friends shall come forward, the friends of Astavet Arita. They will be peace smitting, fighting evil. They will be well thinking, well speaking, well behaving, and following the good law. This is clearly indicating about the Sahabas, who were against all the evils and helped Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam in the propagation of Islam, the correct rectification. Moreover, they followed the Sharia, the good law. They always spoke the truth, they never uttered a falsehood. So this prophecy indicates to the Sahabas of Prophet Muhammad. Further, in the Satir, first epistle of Sasan, it is mentioned that when the Zoroastrians will forsake their religion and will become dissolute, when the Zoroastrians, jab majusi apne mazhab ko bhul jayenge aur gumrah ho jayenge, when the Zoroastrians will forsake their religion and become dissolute, then a man will rise in Arabia whose followers will conquer Persia and subjugate these arrogant Persians. After this, what it says, they will turn, instead of worshipping fire in their own temples, they will turn their faces towards Kaaba of Abraham, peace be upon him, which will be cleared of all idols in worship. And these followers of that prophet, Arabian prophet, will be a mercy unto the world, and they will capture the Zoroastrian territories such as Madain, Tus, Balkh, etc., and the neighboring territories. And the prophet will be a man who will speak beautiful and magnificent things, who will narrate to them beautiful things. This prophecy once again indicates the state. The prophecy referring to Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam and his sahabas when Islam established rule over Persia, present-day Iran, and these people accepted Islam in large numbers. Moreover, in another prophecy, in Bundesh, chapter number 30, verses 6 to 27, it says that Soshen will be the last prophet, indicating that Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam will be the last prophet. Let us now discuss some prophecies in the Buddhist scriptures. In the Buddhist scriptures, this particular prophecy is mentioned in almost all the books. And it is also mentioned in Chakravarti Sinhad Suttanta, part D, chapter number 3, page number 76. Buddha says that in due time, there will arise another Buddha, Maitreya, by the name Maitreya, the benevolent one, a holy one, a supreme one, an enlightened one, endowed with wisdom in conduct, auspicious, knowing the universe. After having received eternal knowledge from his Lord, he will preach it to the rest of the world. And this Buddha to come in the future will preach the same religion as the present Buddha. He will re-establish the correct religion. Moreover, the present Buddha has only hundreds of followers, and the Buddha to come will have thousands of followers. This prophecy refers to Prophet Muhammad by the name Maitreya. The word Maitreya in Sanskrit as well as in Pali means, Pali equivalent Maitreya means merciful. And Prophet Muhammad has been indicated as merciful in several places in the Quran. Also in Surah An-Nisa chapter 21 verse number 107. It says, وَمَا أَرْسَلْنَاكَ إِلَّا رَحْمَةً لِلْعَالَمِينَ. He's a mercy unto the world. And there are various other prophecies. और भी बहुत references ऐसे हैं जिससे ये साबित बिल्कुल साफ जाहिर है कि मोहम्मद सल्लल्लाहु अलैहि वसल्लम को indicate किया गया है तमाम दुनिया की मजहबी किताबों में as the last prophet. Due to time constraints, I'll mention just one more prophecy which is mentioned in the Gospel of Buddha by Karas, page number 214. It says that the Buddha says that in the all ages in the past, whoever have been the Buddhas of the past have had servitors who were just as devoted as Ananda has been to me, and in the future there will be servitors to the Buddhas to come, and they will be as devoted to the respective prophets as Ananda has been to me. And Buddha had a servitor by the name Anas. Buddha had a servitor by the name Ananda. Prophet Muhammad too had a servitor by the name Anas Raziallahu Anhu. And this Anas Raziallahu Anhu served him till the age of 8 years, till the death of the Prophet Muhammad. And he was always there. He was there with him in peace and in war. He was there with him in safety and in danger. He was also there in the Battle of Uhud. He was also there in the Battle of Hunayn besides the Prophet, when there was great danger on the life of the Prophet. He can surely be compared with Ananda, who was with Buddha when the mad elephant rushed at him. Due to time constraints, I'll just give a few references where the prophecy is mentioned about the last prophet. He's been mentioned in Mahaparinibbana Sutta chapter number 2 verse number 32, Mahaparinibbana Sutta chapter number 5 verse number 36, Gospel of Buddha by Karas by page number 217. He's been mentioned also in various other Buddhist scriptures. I'd like to end. Before I end, I'd like to mention one more statement of Buddha. He said that righteousness is the key to salvation. The Quran makes it more explicit, it makes it more elaborate, it makes it more clear. It gives the entire criteria for salvation. It says in Surah Asr, chapter number 3, verse 103, verse number 1-3, وَالْأَسَرْ إِنَّ الْإِنسَانَ لَفِي كُسَرْ إِلَّا الَّذِينَ آمِنُوا وَعَمِلُوا الصَّالِحَاتِ وَتَوَصَوْا بِالْحَقِّ وَتَوَصَوْا بِالصَّبْرِ. कसम है ज़माने की, तमाम इंसान गुमराही में है सिवाय उसके जो ईमान लाए, जो साले आमाल करे, जो लोगों को हक की तरफ बुलाएं, यानी दावत और इस्लाह के काम में लगे रहें, और जो लोगों को सब्र की तरफ बुलाएं. एंड Moreover, it is mentioned, I'd like to end my talk with this verse of the Holy Quran in from Surah Al-Kawthar, chapter number 108, verses 1 to 3. Inna atainaka al-kawthar, fasalli li rabbika wanhar, inna shaniyaka huwal abtar. To thee we have granted the fount of abundance, therefore to thy Lord turn in prayer and sacrifice. For whosoever hates his deed, for him will be cut off all future hope. Waakiru da'wana and alhamdulillahi rabbil alamin.
Thank you.